Tēnā koutou katoa. I'm Malcolm Howard, Technology Facilitator with Team Solutions, University of Auckland. This screencast is about technological modelling and specifically some key messages related to the Level 1 modelling standard AS91048. This is part of a series that we as technology facilitators are doing, covering the externally assessed technology standards. The others done to date cover 1.6 and 1.10. They are available along with other PLD resources and webcasts on our technology wikis at the above addresses. The screencast has been done as part of the SSA PLD contract funded by the Ministry of Education. AS91048 is derived from the Technological Modelling Achievement Objective from the NZC at Curriculum Level 6. So the starting point when understanding the requirements of the standard is to look at what the curriculum says. What is the Achievement Objective at Curriculum Level 6? What are the indicators of progression, and what other curriculum guidance is available? Go to Technology in the NZC tab on Technology Online. Click on the Technological Modelling section on the above diagram, which you will see on the web page. There you can find a video interview with technology facilitator Cheryl Pym about technological modelling, a summary of the key ideas about modelling, indicators of progression, examples, and related resources. For more specific information about technological modelling at Curriculum Level 6, go to the Teaching and Learning Guide for Technology available at TKI at this address. The externally assessed standards are not expected to be tag-ons at the end of the year, so technological modelling should be an integrated part of the overall year's work and should build on teaching and learning about modelling covered in previous years. There should be deliberate acts of teaching related to modelling built into the teaching and learning plan. Evidence can be gathered through the year, even if the actual report writing happens late in the year. The student in the photo has presented a report about the modelling she used in developing a bag, but the technological modelling is just part of what she's covered in the year's programme. A key message about Achievement Standard 91048 is that students should write the report in their own words about their own project. However, the report should not just be a diary of practice. I did this, then that. Here's a photo of me doing this or that. The report should be about the modelling they carried out in developing an outcome they made, and how the evidence they obtained from modelling help them make a better final product. Real projects with stakeholders will make the whole process more authentic. It is possible to also talk about modelling of others, such as from a case study or a visiting expert, but it's important at this level that students focus their report on their own modelling and decision-making process in their practice. Students should say what it is they made so the marker can see if the modelling the student presents in the report makes sense in context of what they are making. E.g., I made this garment and this report is about the modelling I used in the process of making this garment. It's also a good idea to provide the brief within the report so that marker can see what the outcome is, what the brief was, and therefore see if the modelling makes sense in that context. A key understanding that students need to demonstrate is the relationship between the purpose of the modelling, what are they trying to find out, and therefore the type of modelling they carried out or their method of modelling, then the evidence they gain from that modelling, and the decision they made based on that evidence. So by way of an example, the student is making a chair, and this example is available in the 2014 exemplars. At this stage in their practice, they are up to deciding about what padding to put on the chair. So the purpose of the modelling at this stage of practice is to determine the type of foam padding to use. If that's the purpose, the student then selected a method of modelling. In this case, the excerpt from the report shows the method was to try different combinations of foam padding, physically sit on them, and then evaluate each of the options. The student got some evidence. In this case, they got evidence about four different combinations of foam and a reflection about the comfort or otherwise of sitting on that. And then they made a decision. So the report, the excerpts from the report there show method, evidence, decision. The decision I made is to use 50mm U plus 25mm U. That decision is based on evidence and answers the original question. This sort of evidence should be clear in the student's report, showing the reasoning they have done at various stages through their project. It's expected they will use different types of modelling at different stages to get evidence about different things to make various decisions. The standard suggests students need to cover both functional modelling and prototyping. The 2014 assessment report suggests some leeway with an and/or statement, but my recommendation is that reports should cover both. There should be clear evidence of functional modelling and evidence of prototyping. Often students are doing these things without realising that that's what they're doing. So functional modelling is anything the student has done to get evidence to make a decision at some stage in the outcomes design and construction. Prototyping is testing the finished outcome to see if it's fit for purpose. So with reference to the photos above, the chair project on the left, there are two examples of functional modelling, the foam testing we looked at before, and trialling different joint options. And then there's a photo of the finished prototype in location. The dress project on the right shows the finished prototype in the bottom right, and three photos of various types of functional modelling used in the project. For all grades achieve merit excellence, students need to demonstrate an understanding of technical feasibility and acceptability. This relates to the words could and should in the criteria in the standard. Technical feasibility is about, is it possible to make it? Could it be done? Acceptability is about, should it happen? From a social acceptability or environmental acceptability point of view. Social acceptability is about people and the place, so stakeholder opinion is important in influencing the student's decision making. With reference to the example on the screen, the technical feasibility, could it happen? The student could answer, yes, it could. We could make these products. We could taste test them with stakeholder groups. We could find out they like them. And so technically we could make these products. From an acceptability point of view, should we make them? If we consider the fat levels or sugar levels or societal issues such as obesity. So students often get confused trying to understand could and should, or the practical and functional reasoning, which are terms used in the curriculum support material. My recommendation is to stick with the terms technical feasibility and acceptability, which have clear meanings. Ensure students do use these terms in their report so a marker can clearly see that as a result of modelling, the student has considered technical feasibility and acceptability. The key word when stepping up to merit is explain. Explain is different to describing for achieved. Explain means give details about how and why. So a student at merit is likely to have explained why particular methods or modelling was selected, explained their decisions, the why, explained technical feasibility, explained acceptability, and just generally explained how their modelling has informed their practice. At excellence, the key word is discuss. Again, discuss is a step up from explaining at merit or describing it achieved. Discuss means to comment on or about a topic, presenting interpretations and arguments for and against. So for an example, an excellent student may discuss the pros and cons of two possible methods of modelling and say why they selected the one they used. Or they may discuss social acceptability in reference to values and ethics. Or they may discuss modelling practices from industry compared to their own practice. An excellent student will definitely discuss risk and how modelling was used to manage potential risk. Literacy support is important for these externally assessed standards. Ensure students understand the key specialist vocabulary associated with modelling, such as functional modelling, prototyping, technical feasibility, risk, etc. Also ensure students understand and have exemplars of what it means to describe, to explain, or to discuss. Consider pre-writing guides to help students organise their thoughts. Note a pre-writing guide is different to a template for actually writing the report. A pre-writing guide is something you fill in perhaps over a long time, over the period of the year or the period you're working on the project. You gather your notes and your thoughts about modelling, what evidence you got, what decision you made. If you provide a template, for the actual report, be very careful, as overstructured templates can in fact limit students from ability to achieve. Encourage students to write in their own voice, as this helps with authenticity, and certainly provide feedback to the students by commenting on early drafts of their reports. Ensure you've accessed the key NZQA documents each year, the assessment specifications, the assessment report, the schedule, and the latest exemplars. These do change from year to year. It's essential to check them. In fact, I recommend it's good practice to read the last 2 or 3 years' assessment reports to spot reoccurring problems or trends and issues. Look for the most up-to-date exemplars on the NZQA website at this link and read the markers' comments by clicking on the little yellow boxes in the reports. If you decide to share the exemplars with your students, think of deliberate activities to do with the students using the exemplars rather than just making them available with no explicit purpose. For example, it could be, here are the exemplars and the activities to look at the structure of the report, or to look at how the student has addressed technical feasibility or acceptability in the report. That brings us to the end of this short presentation. So in closing, I just want to acknowledge that unless otherwise indicated, all the images used in the screencast are from the 2014 exemplars for Achievement Standard 91048 published on the NZQA website. If you wish to clarify anything in this presentation, please contact the technology facilitator in your region. Thank you.